Hey, Quirrel, what do you know about mixology?
I can dig it. Why?
I think I'm going to have a few old fashions tonight. You think you can handle that?
No sweat. I got the pre-made stuff right here. Old fashioned mix.
No, I want a real old fashioned. So why don't you go to the store and study up? I got some stuff to do. I should be back. I expect my old fashioned at 5 o'clock sharp. Got it?
Yeah, fine, if that's what you want. Jeez Louise.
Old fashions? There's hundreds of them. Each of them a little bit different than the next. I think I'll make a Quirrel old fashioned. See how he likes that.
To the Quirrel Bar, where today we're going to make old fashions Quirrel style. First, a couple of the things that you're going to need to make an outstanding old fashioned. First, your muddling stick. You're going to need this to, in essence, mush up your sugar and fruit and other things that are going to go in that we'll go through. Shot glass for some, or we'll just pour straight. Some fruit that's sliced up and ready for muddling. Sugar cubes instead of powdered sugar or bar syrup. Your Angostura, your bitters, booze wash, and garnishes. So let's start. Okay, I want to start with the glass. You want to use a lower type of a tumbler, also called an old-fashioned glass. It gives you the room to muddle, and it also gives you room to swirl some of the muddled mix before starting. So you've got the right glass. Next, I want to put in a sugar cube, just one. We've tried the bar syrup and we've tried powdered sugar, but a sugar cube works just right. Next, your bitters. There's various brands out there. I've got a French New Orleans style type of bitters, and you just want to put 4 or 5 dashes, just a few dashes in over the sugar. Followed by an orange slice. Not a real big one. You can have a medium size with the rind off of it. I've got one that's all set to drop in, and then take your muddling stick and start muddling. What you want to do is to grind up that sugar enough to where it's dissolved and kind of forms a little bit of a rim around the bottom edge. The orange also should help dissolve that.
Yeah.
You get into variations here. Some people don't believe in muddling the fruit, others do. I just like a little bit stronger fruity flavor in there, which is why I muddle it. But many people don't, and they just use it as garnish. But a Quirrel old fashioned has the orange in it. Next, and this is also a little bit of controversy, what do you use? Some people use a 7-Up sweet soda. I use a sour squirt type of a sour mix instead. A clean old fashioned isn't going to have any wash whatsoever, but I like just a little bit here. Finally, you want to put your booze in, and a lot of people use brandy, but as you saw, I like the Southern Comfort. It's a little bit sweeter, and a lot of people outside the Wisconsin area use either a rye whiskey or something along those lines. No shot glass needed. Finally, you put the ice in afterwards, because otherwise it would have been melting all this time. And now, give it a stir, if you have a stir stick. Garnish with a little bit more fruit. And there you have it, an old-fashioned quirrel style. Cheers.
Here it is, boss, 5 o'clock, on the nose.
Thanks, Quirrel. You're all right. Cheers, sweetie. Mwah. But Quirrel, you gotta make a video about everything, really.